हॅलो फ्रेंड्स, मागच्या दोन व्हिडिओ मध्ये आपण काय काय शिकलो की पहिल्या व्हिडिओ मध्ये आपल्याला की फिजिक्स म्हणजे नेमकं काय, फिजिक्सचं महत्व काय, ते स्टडी केल्यानंतर आपल्याला काय काय माहिती मिळते हे आपण बघितलं. दुसऱ्या व्हिडिओमध्ये आपण बघितलं की बीएससी सेकंडचा फिजिक्सचा सिलेबस काय आहे, ज्याच्यामध्ये पेपर 5, 6, 7, 4 थर्ड सेमिस्टरला, सेमिस्टर 3 ला दोन पेपर तुमच्याकडे आहेत, एक पेपर 5 आणि पेपर 6. त्यापैकी पहिला पेपर आहे पेपर 5, त्याच्यामध्ये पहिला चॅप्टर आहे कायनेटिक थिअरी ऑफ गॅसेस अँड थर्मोमेट्री. सो नाउ वी आर गोइंग टू स्टडी दी कायनेटिक थिअरी ऑफ गॅसेस अँड आफ्टर स्टडींग दी कायनेटिक थिअरी ऑफ गॅसेस वी आर गोइंग टू डील ऑल्सो दी थर्मोमेट्री विच इज रिलेटेड टू दी कायनेटिक थिअरी ऑफ गॅसेस. So now, first of all, we are going to classify the elements. So we know the elements from the periodic table. So elements are classified into 3 groups. Already we know that. That is the solids, then liquids, and gases. So solids are different than the properties. They are compact, then they have a particular shape, size, etc. Liquids also some sort of compact but less than the solids, but they have no shape and size. But gases are the, that is the elements or substances which have no shape and size, also they have the consisting large number of particles. म्हणजे याचा अर्थ काय की समजा आपण गॅस एका सिलेंडर मध्ये भरलं तर काय आपल्याला दिसेल. समजा या गॅस सिलेंडर मध्ये आपण गॅस, एका पर्टिक्युलर गॅसचा आपण गॅस भरलं तर याच्यामध्ये काय दिसेल, आपल्याला डोळ्यानं काही दिसणार नाही. सो दिस गॅस सिलेंडर कन्सिस्ट लार्ज नंबर ऑफ पार्टिकल्स. नाउ टू स्टडी द प्रॉपर्टीज ऑफ दिस, दॅट द गॅस, वी आर गोइंग टू सपोज सम अझम्पशन्स. सो देर आर सर्टन अझम्पशन्स टू स्टडी द कायनेटिक थिअरी ऑफ गॅसेस. There are certain assumptions. What are these assumptions? First assumption is that to study the kinetic theory of gases, we are going to, what is kinetic theory? First of all, we have to clear that. What is kinetic theory means? Kinetic means that is moving, certain velocity. So kinetic means each molecule is having certain kinetic energy. This is due to temperature. So temperature plays more important role in the kinetic energy of a particular gas molecule. So now, to study such type of the gas, behavior of the gases, we are going to suppose some assumptions. So first assumption is that this gas consists very large number of tiny particles. Tiny particles. These particles are called as molecules. See, the gas cylinder consists large number of tiny particles we cannot see by even that is naked eye. These particles are known as molecules. So if we fill the CO2 gas, then all the particles are of CO2. Or these CO2 particles are called as CO2 molecules. Similarly, these particles are also, it is called as the molecules, are spherical in shape. Spherical in shape. Also, they have a rigid. All the gas molecules are rigid and they are under constant motion. No molecule is stable. Every gas molecule is under motion. Constantly they are moving with here and here, there. So now you can see the one video here, that you can observe that video. That video shows you that every particle in that video, every molecule in that video is under motion. So that means the gas consists large number of particles. These they are called as molecules. Each molecule is a spherical in shape. Also it is rigid and under constant motion. No molecule is stable. At any temperature they are always in motion. So now during the motion they collide with other molecules. Suppose this is one gas molecule that travels from one point to another point. During the traveling, different molecules will collide with each. Then this changes its path. Though again, if certain molecule is colliding in this direction, then it changes in this direction. Its direction get changed. So now, we are going to suppose that between two collision, that means if gas molecule collide with other molecule, then collision is perfectly elastic. Perfectly elastic means what? It means that the elastic collision means there is no loss of energy. So every gas molecule collide with other molecules, but the collision is perfectly elastic, there is no loss of energy. Next, so when the gas molecule is traveling, then the volume of the gas molecule is very negligible. So volume is of every molecule, that is, it is all the gas molecules are very tiny. The total volume of the gas is V. As compared to total volume of the gas, the each and every molecule is very tiny. It is supposed that the volume of molecule is negligible. So negligence of volume. Similarly, pressure exerted by each molecule is also negligible. Pressure is also negligible because the pressure exerted by a very tiny molecule on this piston is negligible. So that means we are going to suppose the pressure exerted by gas molecule is very negligible. Next, we are going to suppose that each molecule is having certain kinetic energy. Each molecule is having certain kinetic energy. That kinetic energy depends upon temperature. If we are going to increase the temperature by providing certain amount of energy, heat energy, then its temperature increases. That means each molecule is absorbs that amount of energy and its motion increases, that its velocity increases, its kinetic energy increases. So these are the assumptions. Suppose, once again we are going to revise the assumptions. So gas is nothing but the very large number of tiny particles. These particles are called as molecules. Then each molecule is spherical in shape. Each molecule is rigid and they are under constant motion. No molecule is stable. So now next is assumption is the collision between two molecules is perfectly elastic. That means there is no loss of energy. Again, the volume of each molecule is negligible as compared to total volume of the gas. Similarly, the pressure exerted by each molecule is negligible as compared to piston pressure. Similarly, last one assumption is that the kinetic energy of each gas molecule depends upon the temperature. So temperature plays important role in the kinetic energy of each gas molecule. So these are the some assumptions. So assume such type of, that is the assumptions, we are going to study one by one the properties of the gases. First property of gas is nothing but the free path. First property of gas molecule is free path, and we are going to calculate the average free path, that is called as mean free path. So now tell me, what is free path? So now again consider one gas cylinder here having very large number of molecules. These are enclosed in the cylinder with piston. They are having certain pressure P. Then V is the volume, T is the temperature. Now already we have supposed that each gas molecule is under motion. During the motion, this molecule get collide with the other molecule. So between two collision, the path traveled by this molecule is the free path. Between two collision, there is no force acting on that molecule, and therefore this path traveled is called as free path. So between two collisions, the path traveled by the molecule is straight, having no external force existing on this path, and therefore this path is called free path. So suppose this molecule is at point A and this molecule is trying to go at point B, what will happen? This will not travel in this state because there are large number of molecules, they are colliding with each other. Therefore, each molecule travels in the direction, suppose the lambda one. Suppose I will draw here a big diagram. Suppose this is A point, A molecule, that travels in this direction and collides with the another molecule here. Then it changes its path. It changes its path. Then again it collides with the in the direction. It changes again here. This collides. It again collides here. It will go in the direction. Again collides here. So now after certain collisions, it goes at point B. Now there are different types of different, that is the free paths. So this is the free path between these two collisions. Now suppose this is lambda 1. This is another path, it is called lambda 2. This is lambda 3, lambda 4 and lambda 5. After traveling lambda 5 distances, this molecule goes to point B. That means now we are going to calculate the average of this path traveled by the molecule. That path is called as mean free path. Before mean free path, this type of motion of a gas molecule, that is zigzag motion, it is called as Brownian motion. Brownian motion. Brownian is a botanist who is studying the pollen grains under the microscope. He saw that in the pollen grains in colloidal solutions, they are under constant motion, and therefore similar type of motion is observed in the gases. That means each molecule is traveling and colliding with each other, that between two collisions the path travel is free, that is straight path, it is called as free path, and mean of these free path is called as mean free path. So now if mean is denoted by lambda bar, then what is the mean free path here? Now we can add sum of free paths traveled by the molecule divided by number of collisions. So now lambda bar is nothing but mean free path. It is sum of all free paths, means here there are five paths. So now we are going to add all these lambda 1, lambda 2, lambda 3, lambda 4, lambda 5 divided by number of collisions are 5. So this is the mathematical expression for the mean free path. So general expression for mathematical, we can write lambda 1 plus lambda 2 plus lambda 3 plus and so on up to lambda n in general form, and n is the number of collisions. So this is the general mathematical expression for mean free path. So by using this expression one can find the mean free path of the molecule. But we have already supposed that each molecule is very small, we cannot identify that molecule. Each molecule is traveling with different velocity in different direction. That means you cannot calculate in very smaller time. You cannot calculate lambda 1, lambda 2, lambda 3 and so on. So you cannot calculate the summation of all these paths. You cannot calculate the number of collisions also. And you cannot calculate, after all, mean free path. So now we are going to study how to calculate the mean free path. So suppose there is a expression, we are going to derive the expression for mean free path. So that is the derivation of mean free path. So already we know that the gas molecules all are moving with different directions, different velocities, and that each gas molecule travels a zigzag path in this direction, in this direction, in this direction, any direction we can suppose that. This is a zigzag path traveled by the molecule, this is called Brownian motion. Now we are going to derive the mean free path, approximate value of mean free path. Therefore, now we are going to assume that each molecule is in a constant. All molecules are constant and they are arranged in a one single path like this. So each molecule is spherical, each molecule is having same diameter, and they are, that is, they remain constant in a straight line. Similarly, some other molecules are also remain in another, that is, the line. This is one line, this is one line, this is another line. These are the number of molecules arranged in two lines. So now, suppose that if D is a diameter of molecule, D is a diameter of each molecule, then two molecules get collide with each other when distance between center to center is distance D. So if the center to center distance is D, that is diameter of the molecule, then and then only the molecule collide with the other molecule. Otherwise it will not be possible. So now what we are supposed? This line of molecule is stable. This line of molecule is also stable. And only one molecule under consideration is moving. Suppose in time t, with velocity v, this molecule travels certain distance. Let's say certain distance s is equal to vt. Why vt? Because this travels the distance s with velocity v, and in time t, that is s is equal to vt. So already we know that the expression for lambda is equal to, lambda is nothing but sum of all the, that is the path traveled by the molecule. So path traveled by the molecule is s divided by number of collisions, suppose n, equation number 1. So see, lambda 1 is the path distance traveled by the one molecule from here to here. And there are large number of collisions. Number of collisions are n. So suppose here the n is the number of collision. So already we know that s is equal to v into t. Equation number 2. See here, with velocity v, in time t, it travels the distance vt. So s is equal to vt, s is equal to vt. Now, we are going to study the what is volume of this cylinder in three-dimensional view of this, that is the spherical motion, that is spherical shape of the molecule. Considering the spherical shape, this molecule when travels from this point to this point, it travels as like a cylinder. So now the cylinder is having length s and the radius is equal to d. What is the radius value? That is d is the radius. So now volume of the cylinder is pi d square into s. Do you understand? Pi d square into s. D is the radius of the cylinder, s is the length of the cylinder. So pi d square s is the volume of the cylinder. If suppose there are small n number of particles in the per unit volume, so this small n number of particles in per unit volume, this volume having the number of molecules, so number of molecules in this volume is pi d square s into small n. So now we know that s value, that is s is equal to v into t. So number of collisions is equal to number of molecules in volume, that means number of collisions is given by pi d square vt into n. This is the equation number 3. So pi d square s into n, s is nothing but vt. Already we know that s equal to vt. So now put equation number 2, equation number 3 in equation 1. What will get? Lambda bar is equal to s is nothing but vt divided by, well, that is the n, capital N is nothing but this value, that is pi d square vt into n. So vt vt gets cancelled. So now we will get that lambda is equal to 1 divided by pi d square into n. This is approximate value of mean free path. Why approximate? Because we have supposed that all molecules are stable. Only one molecule is under motion. Already we have supposed that in kinetic theory of gases, every gas molecule is under motion in different direction with different velocities. But here we suppose that to calculate the mean free path, we suppose that only one gas molecule is moving. But after this expression, Boltzmann, the scientist Boltzmann, calculated the value of mean free path considering all molecules are having same speed in the all directions. That means v is a average speed by that the each molecule is traveling. Then he calculated the expression for mean free path is lambda is equal to 3 by 4 1 divided by pi d square. So lambda is equal to 3 by 4 into 1 divided by pi d square n. By 1 divided by d square n is same quantity as we have derived here. So, what is the difference between these two formula? Here, only one molecule is moving, all molecules are stable. Here, all molecules are moving, but with constant speed, that is V, average speed V. And one more scientist, that is Maxwell, he considered that every gas molecule is motion with different velocities in different directions. And mathematically, he calculated the expression for mean free path, and that free path is given by lambda bar is equal to 1 divided by square root of 2, 1 divided by pi d square n. So, this is the correct value of mean free path. For any gas which consists large number of molecules traveling in different directions with different velocities, that means each gas molecule traveling x direction, y direction, z direction, having different velocities. So, x direction, different velocity, y direction, different velocity, z direction, different velocity. So, that means by considering all these things, he derived the expression, that is lambda equal to 1 divided by square root of 1 divided by d square n. This is the exact derivation for mean free path, which can be utilized to study the kinetic theory of gases. Thank you.